Our other big story tonight, the Muskegon River, where homes in both Newaygo and Muskegon counties have been evacuated. We're keeping a close eye on the water tonight. It did climb to more than 13 feet near the Croton Dam. But tonight, it appears the water is slowly receding.
Now, even so, evacuations remain in effect from the Croton Dam all the way down to Muskegon Lake. The mess began after heavy rain this past weekend, and it will probably last several more days.
At 6 o'clock, we took you to a Newaygo County neighborhood that was already underwater.
Tonight, 24 Hour News 8's Heather Walker is in Muskegon County, where residents are bracing for the worst.
Right now, we're on Bain Road off of Maple Island Road, which looks like a river at this moment. It doesn't look much like a road. And just listen, you can hear how quickly this water is moving. But most people living near here are staying put.
It's not good.
Matt Belknap says the Muskegon River has been slowly rising over the past few days, but he's seen the biggest increase today.
All that water back there was still about 10 feet farther back, so it raised a lot in about 8 hours. If the water does go over, we have dug down below the concrete floor, so that way it has to, you know, build up before it's going to come into the basement.
He also has two pumps and a generator ready in addition to more than 100 sandbags. Water is already 4 to 5 feet deep behind his house. Belknap says his biggest concern are the dams failing. The National Weather Service says they should hold up.
We're going to be here all night making sure that water doesn't go over that wall.
The National Weather Service says the Muskegon River will be above flood stage for the rest of the week into next week, possibly until Wednesday. In Muskegon County, Heather Walker, 24 Hour News 8.
Upriver in Newaygo County, more than 100 homes there have been flooded to some extent, and one of the hardest hit neighborhoods is an area known as Devil's Hole. Residents there have all evacuated, though some did come back today to see the damage firsthand. And while the river appears to have crested, the county still wants folks in the flood-prone areas to stay back.
The difficult thing when people don't evacuate is that puts our first responders at risk. We have to choose if this is a life and death situation. We'll send our first responders in to help evacuate out.
And as Heather just mentioned, the National Weather Service says it could take a week before the river drops below flood stage levels.